James, we all know that a lot of our employees are working from home or from office. And the dynamic of the culture has changed, the workforce has changed. In that sense, how can employers engage with their employees? How is the employee engagement has changed during pandemic times? What tips do you have in that category?
So here's my take. I think that people talk about Zoom fatigue all the time. I think that Zoom fatigue is very specific towards large group intercompany meetings. My advice is to reduce the amount of actual like company-wide or group-wide meetings that you have, but increase the amount of one-on-one time you have. I think you should be talking on a personal level with everyone on your team once a week, ideally, depending on how big your team is, or twice or once every other week as a minimum. And just make the conversation more open-ended, making sure you're hearing them, making sure it's their time, you're giving them the floor. The most critical thing that I think we have to worry about with employee burnout is not knowing what we don't know and not knowing when someone's having a bad time of it. And obviously for management, this is going to be a little more time intensive, but I think if you have your finger on the pulse of what your employees are thinking, how they're feeling about stuff, what their ideas are, you know, it's invaluable. So I think, you know, less group time, more one-on-one time is kind of the first thing. The second thing, which we've had is really important is and this is in general, but I think especially now, let your employees drive more initiatives, stuff that's outside of their normal job realm. So like my team, like I always encourage everyone to get involved in content creation, right? And we're recruiters, we're not marketers, we're not content marketers, but let people kind of expand, you know, and have a voice or whatever their thing is. We've had a lot of community events. We kicked off like a DEI committee that's actually driven by employees. So, you know, if there's different things around your organization that you want to improve upon, do those things, make it something that your employees can actually drive and lead themselves, that gets them a little bit outside of the same old of their everyday. I think just it gives them a little more, it's a little more enriching, feels a little more fulfilling, and I think will definitely help with your engagement.
Yeah, those are great. And I also read, I think a while ago for Gallup survey, they were doing about employee engagement that yes, employees are disengaged, but the managers are more disengaged than the employees. So if the manager is disengaged, of course the employer will be disengaged, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, for the management and the leaders above them that need to make sure everything's kind of getting done. Like overall, like it's, you want to make sure you're having more individual conversations, but you're not taking it to a micromanagement level. You know what I mean? That's not the goal of it. The goal is more of just having open-ended conversations with people. As opposed to like, where are you with your metrics? Where's this project? Like you need to make it more kind of focused on just making sure you're actually hearing people. Cause once you do that, I think that a lot of the challenges start to solve themselves.
Yeah. And of course everyone is working from home. There's already tension there, you know, they are the kids, they're the pets. So also make sure understand where the employee is setting up from home and having this more personal connections with them. And I hope that this conversation continues once this pandemic is over and everyone goes back to the office and not to turn the old system.
Yeah.
Thank you 300%. For those great tips, James. Thank you very much. And again, for the audience watching this, and if you have any other tips in terms of employee engagement, please leave it a comment below and tune in for my final question with James tomorrow.